Okay, we were about 59 or so. By now we are just 36. A lot of our mates, I'm sure, ask questions and they make a decision to leave us. But some of us still stay and we are doing well. There are a lot of questions, but the one question is, where are you getting your information from? And what are you basing on to make your decisions, all right? So let's make some few statistics. Now, before we go to the statistics, what is the worst case scenario with the eye? That is my first question. Obviously, it is blindness. Can we all close our eyes for just a minute? Exactly, you can open it now. So now, in the moment when you close your eyes, that is what blind people experience every other second in their lives. Okay. Aside that, there are people with vision impairments, which include the refractive errors, low vision, etc. Now, a Christian, so I go by the Bible, and the Bible says that the eye is the window to the body. That's how important our eyes are. Okay. So just as you close your eyes, everything is so dark. That's the worst case scenario for a blind person or an individual when it comes to vision. Would you want that for yourself or would you want that for a family member? Now we notice that there is a problem, okay? And anytime there is a problem, there is a need for somebody to come solve that problem or intervene, okay? So now let's move to the statistics. Now the world population stands about 7.6 billion now. And according to the WHO fact sheet in October 2017, there are 253 million people who live with vision impairment. 36 million are blind. 273 million have a vision impairment. And 81% are aged 50 years and above. So there's a problem. People are blind already, and more people are getting blind in the world. All right, now let's move on. Now, according to the fact sheet, it says that two of the main causes of this vision impairment is uncorrected refractive error, where optometrists are the primary eye care specialist that anybody is going to encounter when it comes to that field, as well as unoperated cataract. So you talk about refractive error, you talk about cataract, and the optometrist is there. Okay. To the next slide. So this is the reality. In every 5 seconds, a person goes blind. And so on and so forth. And so there is a problem, and there is a need for an intervention, somebody to solve that problem, and that is you sitting right there in front of me. Okay, so our next slide. Now, the same fact she said that over 80% of all vision impairment can be prevented or cured. So now that's the great news. Yay, hallelujah for us. Because then, if it can be prevented and it can be cured, then it means our presence are extremely needed. Optometrists are extremely needed every single and any other day. Okay. Now let's come home to Ghana. Our population stands at 28.21 million. And according to the Ghana Blindness and Visual Impairment Study, and this is by Dr. Adi in 2016, he said that the prevalence rate of blindness in Ghana now is 0.74%. And it means over 190,000 people are blind in Ghana. They're already blind, and more people are gradually getting to that point. Okay. Now, the number of optometrists, according to the Ghana Optometric Association, GOA, 190. Obviously, this is not the exact number because some haven't registered with GOA, and some have probably traveled to practice. But we are basing this statistics on the figure provided by GOA. Now we look at 190,000 people blind already in Ghana and only 190 doctors available. Then it means that to everyone of optometrists there are over 1,000 blind patients to attend to, as well as all the other conditions that I've not mentioned. So then there is the need for all of us to go through this program and this education and become optometrists. Alright, so truth is, you are extremely needed in the optometry profession, both here in Ghana and the entire world. I want us to take the you are and put I am and take this together. Can we do that? Okay, so one, two, three, go. I am extremely needed in the optometry profession, both here in Ghana and the entire world. So I want us all to leave with this message. You are extremely needed. Think about your mom, your mothers, your fathers, your grandfathers and grandmothers, your aunties, your friends, your neighbors, your sisters, who are every day coming into contact with conditions that can affect their eye, that can eventually lead them to blindness, and who need you to be in that particular position where you are now to attend to them. Okay, so for the sake of those people, stay in optometry. Alright. Now, where do you fit? There are a whole bunch of specialties in optometry. You can look at pediatric, geriatric, orthotic, sports vision, contact lens, public health, and all the others. You can even venture into teaching and research. And with this, I would say that if you need more information, do more research, and we have our lectures available, who will always be ready to listen to us and help us with any questions we have. Okay, so know that there are lots of branches that you can go into as an optometrist. The next one is opportunity at your doorstep. First of all, you can have your own clinical practice. So the biochemical students at the time, I think that, oh well, for me, I know a lot of optometrists own clinics, but I don't know where your source got this information from. And that's the truth. We have first visit from our very own doctor, Kobia, and most of the doctors in the department have their claim. Unfortunately, we couldn't bring it, but then they do, and we appreciate that. And some other popular ones around. As an optometrist, you can own your private clinic after school, so you can look at that. The other thing too is, in the security service, Ghana Police, Ghana Armed Forces, there are some optometrists who are there after school. You can go to the security service to be part of them as an optometrist. Also in academia, there are lots of opportunities. And even now in Ghana Medical School, there's a program. If you still want to be a medical doctor after optometry, you can go through 4 years at least and you become a medical doctor. That's up to you. But you can be a medical doctor and a certain ophthalmologist as an optometry. That's if you go to Legon and do the 4 years, right? Aside that, you can go to other universities all over the world, either the UK, the States, Australia, anywhere you want to do further studies, you can go. Most of our lecturers have done that, and if you wish to know more about that, I would entreat you to visit them and talk more to them. Okay. So now, we know that there is a problem, and people are already in the system trying to solve this problem, but the number is not enough. And so it means that more hands are needed, more of us are needed in the profession. And so what can we do as we gradually get to the end of our studies here? The first thing I'll talk about is to work on our CWA to get the best average. And this was given to me by the dad who, when I spoke to him about this presentation, he said, tell them that they should get the best average that they can ever have in the world. Okay, so it's never too late. I know some of us don't like our average, our CWA, what we have at the moment. You just see your list and be like, oh, not again. You keep dropping. I think you say, you are not going up the ladder. But please, that doesn't call for giving up, okay? Do more. If it means talking to your friends in the class who you think they are very good, talk to them, have tutorials with them. Our teaching assistants are available, talk to them. Lectures are even available to help us, okay? So that, because if you want to fail that, then your CWA will come into play, alright? Also, you have to develop the clinical skills. Lucky for us, we have a clinic now. You can always go there at any time to work on your clinical skills. And another thing too, you can take online courses, example for Sarah and others. Even on YouTube, there are lots of videos over there for us to learn a lot, both with the the theory and the practical. And then my most favorite one is to make use of the presence of our awesome lecturers and teaching assistants around. They are always ready to listen to us. Okay, let's make good use of them. They are here for us. So in any position you find yourself thinking that you need help, please do well to see our lecturers and they will help you with that. Now this is my final slide, and I want to say to each and every one of us that you are exactly where you need to be I don't know what your questions are. I don't think I've been able to help you relax and feel like you're having optometry. But all I know is there's a problem and there's a need to solve that problem. The people available are not enough, so more people are needed, and that's where I come in. So I'm going to do my best to be the best optometrist so I can be part of the people solving this problem. Like I said, my name is Antoinette Antwi, and thank you so much for listening to me this afternoon.